everyone. This is Dr. P. Srilata, Associate Professor, Department of Mathematics, Institute of Aeronautical Engineering, Hyderabad. So in this session, I am going to discuss about problems on sampling distribution. So already we have discussed sampling distribution. Okay, so based on that, we are going to solve some problems. Okay, so first problem is, a sample consists of 5 numbers, 2, 3, 6, 8, 11. Consider all possible samples of size 2, which can be drawn without replacement from this population. Find first one, mean of the population, second one, variance of the population, third one, standard deviation of the population, fourth one, mean of the sampling distribution, fifth one, variance of the sampling distribution, sixth one, standard deviation of the sampling distribution. So observe the question carefully. So a population consists of five members. That means here they have given that population size they have given that 5. So those are the population is 2, 3, 6, 8, 11. Okay, and consider all possible samples of size 2. So what is sample size? Sample size, population size is denoted with capital N. Okay, so here capital N is 5 and the sample size is denoted with small n. Okay, so that is small n equal to 2. So which can be drawn without replacement. So from this population, very very important here. So which can be drawn without replacement. So which can be drawn with replacement. With replacement is nothing but infinite population. So find. So first one is mean of the population, second one is variance of the population, and third one is standard deviation of the population, fourth one is mean of the sampling distribution, and fifth one is variance of the sampling distribution, and sixth one is standard deviation of the sampling distribution. So what is the formula for mean of the sampling distribution? So we know that the mean of the population is denoted with mu, and that is equal to 1 by capital N into summation capital Xi. So these are all capital Xi values. That means this is capital X1, this is X2, X3, X4, X5. Okay. So this is the formula for mean of the population. So what is variance of the population? So variance of the population is denoted with sigma square. So that is equal to 1 by capital N into summation Xi minus mu whole square. Summation Xi minus mu whole square, or sigma Xi minus mu whole square. Okay. So next one is standard deviation of the population. So standard deviation of the population, that is nothing but under root of variance, under root of variance of the population. So next one is mean of the sampling distribution. So we will discuss later. So first we have to solve these three. Okay, so first one, given that N equal to 5. So already we have discussed capital N, population size. They have given that the population size is 5. So that's why capital N equal to 5. And the sample size is 2. So they have given that sample size N equal to 2. So sample size N equal to 2. And first we need to find the mean of the population. So here they have given that the population is 2, 3, 6, 8, 11. So that means this is X1, X2, X3, X4, X5. So what is the formula for mean of the population? So mean of the population is mu equal to summation X by N, or 1 by N into summation Xi. So mu equal to 1 by N into summation Xi. So Xi means 1 by N into summation Xi values are X1. So this is X1 plus X2 plus X3 plus X4 plus X5. Okay, so that's why 1 by N, capital N, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So that is 1 by 5 into 2 plus X3, X2 is 3 plus 6 plus 8 plus 11. So if you solve this one, we will get 6. Okay, if you simplify this one, we will get 6. So that means mean of the population mu equal to 6. Mean of the population mu equal to 6. So next one is variance of the population. variance of the population. So what is the formula for variance of the population? Variance of the population is denoted with sigma square, and that is nothing but 1 by n into summation xi minus mu whole square. Summation xi minus mu whole square. So we know that these are all xi values, okay? So x1, x2, x3, x4, x5. So these are all xi values. And what about mu? So already we have solved mu equal to 6. Mu equal to 6. So that means sigma square equal to summation xi minus xi minus mu whole square divided by n. So that is equal to, so first value is 2 minus 6, so because here we have xi minus mu, okay? So xi value is, first x1 value is 2 minus 6, mu value is 6, so 2 minus 6 whole square, plus next value is 3 minus 6 whole square, next 6 minus 6 whole square, plus 8 minus 6. So because the mu value is 6 and xi values are x1, x2, x3, x4, xy values are 2, 3, 6, 8, 11. So that's why 8 minus 6 whole square plus 11 minus 6 whole square divided by n. So what is n value here? We know that the sample size, population size, n equal to 5. So simplify this one, we will get variance of the population is 10.8. So next one is standard deviation of the population. So what is standard deviation? So we know that always standard deviation is nothing but sigma is nothing but and a root of variance. So here we have 10.8. So sigma is nothing but and a root of 10.8. So that will be 3.29. Okay, so standard deviation of the population is here 3.29. So next one, so we have solved the mean of the population, variance of the population and standard deviation of the population. So now we need to solve these three. So that is mean of the sampling distribution. So what is the formula for mean of the sampling distribution? So mean of the sampling distribution is mu x bar equal to, so mean of the sampling distribution is denoted with mu x bar. So that is equal to, so here what is our question here? So observe the question carefully. So here our question is for with replacement. So in with replacement, so what is the mean of the sampling distribution? So in with replacement, how many samples will be there? So in with replacement, n power n samples will be there. So based on that, we need to write the formula. So mu x bar equal to 1 by n power n. So because we are doing for with replacement, that means we are doing for infinite population. So that's why mu x bar equal to 1 by n power n into summation xi bar. So what about xi bar? Xi bar is nothing but sample means. Okay, so sample means are xi bars. So what about the samples? Samples are xi's. Okay, so from this population, so from this population we need to find the samples first. Okay, so first we need to find the samples, after that we need to find the sample means. So then only we can find mean of the sampling distribution. So but because mean of the sampling distribution, mu x bar equal to 1 by n power n into summation xi bar. So 1 by n power n into summation xi bar. So what about the variance of the sampling distribution? So variance of the sampling distribution is sigma square x bar. So variance of the sampling distribution is always denoted with sigma square x bar. So that is equal to 1 by n power n. So why we are writing 1 by n power n only? We need to write n power nc, no? Ncn, no? So because why we are writing n power n means, so here in our question we have to draw for with replacement, okay? So for with replacement, that means for infinite populations we are doing, okay? So that's why that will be sigma square x bar equal to 1 by n power n into summation xi bar minus mu x bar whole square, Okay, so xi bars. So xi bar is nothing but sample means. What about mu x bar? Mu x bar is mean of the sampling distribution. So mu x bar is mean of the sampling distribution. Okay, so variance of the sampling distribution, sigma square x bar equal to 1 by n power n summation xi bar minus mu x bar whole square. So what about the standard deviation of the sampling distribution? So that is sigma x bar equal to under root of always. So what about the standard deviation? We know that the standard deviation is nothing but under root of variance. So here variance of the sampling distribution, standard deviation of the sampling distribution sigma x bar equal to under root of variance of the sampling distribution. So that is the formula. So next, so before going to find the sampling distribution, first of all we need to find samples and also sample means. First we need to find samples, okay, after that sample means. So first here I am finding samples from those populations. So what is the population here? So for population we are having 2, 3, 6, 8, 11. So this is the population, okay? So this is our population and the population size capital N equal to here we are having 5. Okay, so now we are doing for with replacement. So sampling with replacement. So that is nothing but infinite population. In sampling we know that we have a note based on this, right? So that is in sampling with replacement, how many samples can be drawn? Okay, so in with replacement we can draw n power n samples. Okay, in with replacement we can draw n power n samples. So let us check. Okay, so n power n, so n is capital N is nothing but 5. What about the sample size? Sample size is, you know, is here they have given that sample size is 2. Okay, so that's why that is equal to small n equal to 2. So here we need to draw n power n samples. That means capital N is 5 and small n is 2. So 5 power 2, 25 samples can be drawn. So here we can draw 25 samples. Okay, in with replacement. So here observe carefully how many samples are there. What is the population here? So the population consists of how many numbers? 2, 3, 6, 8, 11. So the population consists of 2, 3, 6, 8, 11. So that's why from this we have to find the samples. So the samples can be drawn with replacement means repetition allowed. Okay, so that means, so 2, 2. So here I am drawing 2, 2, 2, 3. So 2, 2, 2, 3, 2, 6, 2, 8, 2, 11. So 2, 2, 2, 3, 2, 6, 2, 8, 2, 11. So next one is 3, 2. Next 3, 3. Okay, so next one is 3, 6, 3, 8, 3, 11. So 3, 2, 3, 3, 6, 3, 8, 3, 11. So next one is 6, 2, 6, 3, 6, 6, 6, 8, 6, 11. So 6, 2, 6, 3, 6, 6, 6, 8, 6, 11. So next one is 8, 2. So 2, 3, 6, 8, 11, right? So next one is 8, 2. So next one is 8, 3, 8, 6, 8, 8. Next 8, 11. So 8, 2, 8, 3, 8, 6, 8, 8, 11. So last one is 11, 2, 11, 3, 11, 6, 11, 8, 11, 11. Okay, so in the ordered pair we have to take. So 11, 2, 11, 3, 11, 6, 11, 8, 11, 11. So we have to write the sampling distribution in the bracket. Okay, those are the samples we are taking. Okay, so here, so how many samples are there? Let me check. So those are, we need 25 samples, right? So here in with replacement we can draw 25 samples. So whether 25 samples are there or not we need to check. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25. Total how many samples are there? 25 samples are there. Okay, so in with replacement, So in with replacement we can draw total 25 samples. Okay, so that means these are Xi's. Okay, so these are the samples, only samples. Samples are Xi's. Okay, but we need Xi bars, right? We need to find Xi bars. Okay, so in the formula we have Xi bar, so that's why Xi bar is nothing but average. Okay, so means are nothing but averages. So we have to find the average of this one. So average of this one is 2 plus 2 by 2, so that is 2. So next one is 2 plus 3 by 2, so that is 2 plus 3, so that is 5 by 2, that is 2.5. so like that 2 plus 6 by 2 8 by 2, so 2 plus 6 by 2, so this is 2 plus 8 by 2, so this is 2 plus 11 by 2, so like that we can find up to 11 plus 11 by 2. So we need to find the averages. Averages are nothing but the sample means. Okay, so sample means those are nothing but Xi bars, averages. Okay, so average of those values. Okay, 2 plus 2 by 2 is 2. So here 2 plus 2 by 2 is 2. So like that 2 plus 3 by 2. So 2 plus 3 by 2 is 2.5. Okay, so next value is 2 plus 6 by 2, 8 by 2. So that is 4. Okay, so like that we can find all the values, all the averages. Okay, so this is 11 plus 8 by 2. So that is 19 by 2, right? So 19 by 2 is, that is 9.5. And the next one is 11 plus 11 by 2. So 11 plus 11 by 2 is 11. So that's why that is 11. Okay, so these are the Xi bars. Xi bars means sample means. Xi bars means sample means. Okay. Next, so what is our fourth question here? So in this, our fourth question is we need to find mean of the sampling distribution. So here the mean of the sampling distribution, or the mean of the sampling distribution of means, both are same, is mu x bar equal to, so that is denoted with, mean of the sampling distribution is denoted with mu x bar. Here we are taking with replacement, so with replacement, so that's why we need to write 1 by n power n. So that is summation xi bars. Xi bar is xi bar, these are all xi bar values, right? So these are all xi bar values, so that's why we need to take the summation of those values. Okay, so summation of those values, so this is nothing but 1 by n power n. So already we have solved, so n power n is nothing but 25, n power, so 5 power 2, that is 25. Okay, so here we need to write, that is 25 into summation of xi. So here these are xi values, so sum of these values. Okay, so that means 2 plus 2.5 plus 4 plus 4.5 plus 6.5, sorry, 5 plus 6.5 plus 2.5 plus 4.5, 5.5 plus 7 plus 4 plus 4.5. So like that we can solve up to 9.5 plus 11. Okay, so these are the values to find 2 plus 2.5 plus 4 plus and so on up to 11. Okay, so divided by 25 means here we will get 6. Otherwise we have note, no, in the note we have mentioned in the previous class, we know that mu of x bar equal to x, sorry, mu of x bar is always mu, so that is nothing but mean of the population. So mean of the population is always equal to mean of the sampling distribution. Okay, so mean of the sampling distribution. So check mean of the population. So what we have find for mean of the population. So we know that mean of the population is 6. Okay, so mean of the population is 6. Okay, so that's why we can directly write that is mu x bar equal to 6. Okay, so otherwise you have to calculate these values, then we will get 6 only. So because always mu x bar equal to mu. So mean of the sampling distribution is always equal to mean of the population. So next one is variance of the sampling distribution, or variance of the sampling distribution of means. So that is denoted with sigma square. So sigma square x bar, so that is equal to 1 by n power n summation xi minus mu x bar whole square. Okay, so 1 by n power n, so 1 by n power n is 25. So what about xi values? So these are all xi values, right? So these are all xi values. Okay, so 2, 2.5, 4, 4, 5, 6.5 up to 11. So these are all xi values. Okay, so that means sample means. So we need to take sample means. That means 2 minus, what about mu x bar? Mu x bar means 6. So 2 minus 6 whole square. So next value is 2.5. So 2.5 minus 2.5 minus 6 whole square plus next value is 4. Okay, so 4 minus, so that is 4 minus 6 whole square. So plus and so on up to last value is, so our last value is 11. So 11 minus mu, 11 minus mu x bar. Mu x bar is 6, okay. So 11 minus 6 whole square, okay. So calculate these values, we will get this one, 5.40, okay. So otherwise, we have in our note, in the previous session already we have discussed, so sigma square x bar is always not equal to sigma square, okay. So here sigma square is, x bar is 5.40 and that is not equal to, whether it is equal to or not, we will check. So that is sigma square, that is nothing but 10.8. Okay, so 10.8, so that is not equal, right? So when it is, it will be equal, so we know that, so this is with replacement, right? So this is, sorry, this is with replacement, so with replacement or infinite population. So infinite population, so what is the formula? So sigma square x bar equal to sigma square by n. So sigma square is 10.8 divided by n is 2. So if you solve this one, we will get 5.40, right? So this is the answer, okay? So after completion of this one, you can check this also, okay? So by using note, okay? So what is the note here? So in with replacement, or in infinite population, variance of the sampling distribution is equal to sigma square by n. Variance of the sampling distribution is equal to sigma square by n. So you can check this one, okay, after completion of variance of the sampling distribution. So next one is standard deviation of the sampling distribution. So we know that the standard deviation is nothing but under root of variance. That means sigma square x bar equal to, sorry, sigma x bar equal to standard deviation of sampling distribution, that is sigma x bar equal to under root of sigma square x bar. So that is under root of 5.40. So that is 2.32. So this is the required solution. Okay. So next. So one more problem is there. A sample consists of, so same problem, but here we are using without replacement. Okay. So a population consists of 5 members, 2, 3, 6, 8, 11. Okay. So consider all possible samples of size 2. So which can be drawn without replacement for this population, find. First one, mean of the population. Second one is variance of the population, standard deviation of the population. Fourth one is variance of the sampling distribution. Sorry, mean of the sampling distribution. Fifth one is variance of the sampling distribution. And the sixth one is the standard deviation of the sampling distribution. Okay, so we have already discussed in the previous slide. So that is a previous problem. So the population consists of 5 members. That means the xi values are 2, 3, 6, 8, 11. Okay, here population size. So population size is capital N. And what about the sample size? In the question they have mentioned that the sample size, so sample size is small n, okay? So in without replacement, that means, in without replacement means without replacement. So that is nothing but finite population. So in finite population, we can draw ncn samples. In finite population or in without replacement, we can draw ncn samples. Okay, so first we are going to find mean of the population. We know that mean of the population is mu, so that is equal to, already we have discussed, mu equal to 1 by n summation xi bar, capital xi bar, 1 by capital n. And the variance of the population is sigma square, that is equal to 1 by n into summation xi minus mu whole square, capital xi minus mu whole square. This is the formula for variance of the population. So what about standard deviation? So we know that standard deviation is under root of variance. Okay, so next one is the sampling distribution of means, mean of the sampling distribution. So that means mu x bar equal to, so 1 by So here, observe carefully. So we are doing for without replacement. That means finite population. In finite populations, how many samples can be drawn? NCN samples can be drawn. So that means that is NCN into sigma. Here we need to find xi bars. So first of all, we need to find samples. That means xi. Okay. So after that, we need to find sample means. So xi bars. Okay. So next one is variance of the sampling distribution. Sigma square x bar equal to 1 by ncn summation xi bar minus mu x bar whole square. The formula is mu x bar whole square. And the next one is standard deviation of the sampling distribution. So that is always standard deviation of the sampling distribution is denoted with sigma x bar. That is nothing but under root of standard deviation of the variance of the sampling distribution. So let us do this problem. So given that capital N equal to 5, so population size already we have discussed. So population size is denoted with N, so that is nothing but 5. Okay, so capital N equal to 5 and the sample size is 2. Okay, so first we need to find mean of the population, mu equal to summation xi minus N. Okay, so xi values capital xi. Okay, so mu equal to summation capital xi by n. So here the values are 2, 3, 6, 8, 11. So that means average of these values. That means 2 plus 3 plus 6 plus 8 plus 11 by n value. N population size is 5. So the answer is 6. Okay, so next one is variance of the sampling distribution. Okay, so variance of the sampling distribution is denoted with sigma square. So that is nothing but 1 by capital N xi minus mu whole square, summation xi minus mu whole square. Okay, so these are xi values. That means 2 minus 6 whole square plus 3 minus 6 whole square plus 6 minus 6 whole square plus 8 minus 6 whole square plus 11 minus 6 whole square divided by n. Capital N is 5. So capital N is 5. So that means, so that is equal to, so 2 minus 6 whole square plus 3 minus 6 whole square plus 6 minus 6 whole square plus 8 minus 6 whole square plus 11 minus 6 whole square. So that means if you solve this one, we will get 10.8. okay, so that is sigma square equal to, okay. So next one is standard deviation of the population. So standard deviation of the population is nothing but the sigma equal to under root of variance. Okay, so under root of, so that is nothing but under root of variance is 10.8. so sigma equal to under root of 10.8 is 3.29 something. Okay, so next we need to find the fourth one is mean of the sampling distribution. So mean of the sampling distribution formula is mu x bar equal to 1 by ncn summation xi bar. So before going to start this problem, this solution, so first we need to find the samples xi. Okay, so after that we need to find the sample means in without replacement. In without replacement we need to find for without replacement. So sampling without replacement, sampling without replacement, that is nothing but a finite population. That is nothing but sampling without replacement, that is nothing but finite population. In finite population we can draw NCN samples. Okay, so NCN samples can be drawn. So in without replacement or in finite population we can draw NCN samples. NCN samples. Okay, so that's why NCN, we know that population size is 5 and sample size is 2. So 5C2 is 10. Okay, so 10 samples can be drawn. So here we are having 2, 3, 6, 8, 11. So without replacement means there is no repetition. There is no repetition. Okay, so that's why here we can't take 2, 2. So here 2 is repeating, right? So that's why we need to take 2, 3, 2, 6, 2, 8, 2, 11. So 2, 3, 2, 6, 2, 8, 2, 11. So like that. So 3, 2. So coming to this point. Okay. So here 2, 3 or 3, 2. Both are same, right? So 2, 3 and 3, 2. So both are same. That means this is repeating. Okay, so this is repeating. So that's why we can't write 3 comma 2. So we can't write 3 comma 2 and also we can't write 3 comma 3. So here 3 is also repeating. So that's why we have to take 3 comma 6, 3 comma 8, 3 comma 11. Okay, so 3 comma 6, 3 comma 8, 3 comma 11. So next one. So 6 comma 2. Okay, 2 comma 6 is also there. Already we have 2 comma 6. Okay, so 2 comma 6 is there. So that's why we can't write 6 comma 2. Okay, so 6 comma 2 we can't write. Next one is 6 comma 3. So already we have 3 comma 6. Okay, so 3 comma 6 is there. So that's why we can't write 6 comma 3. And also we can't write 6 comma 6. 6 is repeating here. So that's why we need to write 6 comma 8 and 6 comma 11. So 6 comma 8 and 6 comma 11. And last one is we can't write 11 comma 2. We can't write 11 comma 3. 11 comma 2 is there. 11 comma 3 is there. And 11 comma 6 is also there. And 11 comma 11 we can't write. Okay. So that's why we need to write. Okay. Sorry. That's why we need to write 8 comma 11 only. So we can't write 8 comma 2, 8 comma 3, 8 comma 6, 8 comma 8. Only so then for that we need to write 8 comma 11. So like that 11 comma 2 already it has done, and 11 comma 3 and 11 comma 6, 11 comma 8, but we can't write 11 comma 11. So the possible samples are so here the possible samples are 2 comma 3, 2 comma 8, 2 comma 2 comma 6, 2 comma 8, 2 comma 11, 3 comma 6, 3 comma 8, 3 comma 11, 6 comma 8, 6 comma 11, and 8 comma 11. So total how many samples are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So 10 samples satisfied. So in without replacement. So without replacement means there is no repetition. Okay. So in without replacement, we can draw NCN samples. We can draw NCN samples. That means 10 samples can be drawn. So here these are the samples. Samples. These are the samples. Sample means XI values. So these are all XI values. But we need XI bars. Okay. So but we need XI bars. So that's why. So we need to take the average, XI bar. Bar is nothing but mean. Mean is nothing but average. Okay. So mean means here average. So that's why we need to take the average of these samples. Okay. So first sample average is 2 plus 3 by 2. Second sample average is 2 plus 6 by 2. Third sample 2 plus 8 by 2. 2 plus 11 by 2. So this is 3 plus 6 by 2. So 3 plus 8 by 2. 3 plus 11 by 2. So 6 plus 8 by 2, 6 plus 11 by 2, 8 plus 11 by 2. So if you solve these values, we can find 2 plus 3 by 2 is 2.5. So next one is 2 plus 6 by 2. So that is 4. Okay. So like that we can find the average of all those values. So these are all XI bars. Okay. So these are all sample means averages. Averages or sample means are XI bar values. XI bar values. Okay. So now our next question is, our fourth question is, find the mean of the sampling distribution. Mean of the sampling distribution where we have to find in without replacement or in finite population. So in finite population, this is for without replacement or in finite population. Finite population. So that means here we can draw NCN samples. So that's why we need to write in the formula mean of the sampling distribution or mean of the sampling distribution of means is mu x bar equal to 1 by NCN summation xi bar. Mu x bar equal to 1 by NCN summation xi bar. So that is equal to, so 1 by NCN already we have solved. How many samples are there? 10. So that's why this is 10. And summation of xi bar, that means, so sum of all these values, so that is 2.5 plus xi values. Okay, so xi bar values, that means 2.5, 4 plus 5 plus 6.5 plus and so on up to 9.5. Okay, so simplify this one, you will get 6. Okay, so and also we know that in the note we have one point is there, that is mu x bar is always equal to mu. So mu is nothing but mean of the population and mu x bar is mean of the sampling distribution. Already we have solved mu. So mu value is 6, right? So mu equal to 6. So this is also we can find 6. Okay, so otherwise if you find mean of the population directly, you can write 6. Okay, no need to calculate all these values. Okay, so next one is variance of the sampling distribution. Variance of the sampling distribution or variance of the sampling distribution of means. The formula is sigma square x bar equal to 1 by ncn summation xi bar minus mu x bar whole square. So sigma square x bar equal to, we know that the values are xi bar. And what about ncn? Ncn is nothing but 10. And xi bar values. Xi bar values are here 2.5, 4. So 4, 2.5 minus 6 whole square. First value is. Plus 4 minus 6 whole square. Plus 5 minus 6 whole square. Plus 6 minus 6.5 minus 6 whole square. Plus and so on. 9.5 minus 6 whole square. Okay. So 2.5 minus 6 whole square. Plus 4.6. 4 minus 6 whole square. Plus and so on. 9.5 minus 6 whole square. Divided by NCN. So why we are writing here NCN? So here we are doing for without replacement. Without replacement. In without replacement, we can draw NCN samples. Okay. So that's why that is NCN. So here NCN is 5C2. So that's why we can write that is 10. Okay. So after simplification we will get 4.05. So otherwise we have note. Okay, so that is we know that sigma square x bar is always not equal to sigma square, but when it is possible, sigma square x bar equal to sigma square by n into n minus n by n minus 1. So this is for without replacement. So without replacement are for finite population. So finite population. So for finite population, we can take sigma square x bar equal to sigma square by n, n minus n by n minus 1. We know that sigma square is 10.8, right? So sigma square is 10.8 this is 10.8 divided by n is 2 and capital N is 5 minus 2 by 5 minus 1. Or you can solve like this also. Okay, by using this condition you can solve. We can find sigma square x bar. Okay, so otherwise case you can find like this. Okay, otherwise you can check whether it is whether these two are correct or not. Okay. So, standard deviation of the sampling distribution. We know the standard deviation is nothing but under root of variance. Okay. So, that's why standard deviation of the sampling distribution is standard deviation of the sampling distribution is under root of variance. So, that means under root of variance means under root of variance of the sampling distribution. So, under root of 4.05, here you will get 2 point something. Okay. So, this is the standard deviation of the sampling distribution. Thank you.
Like, share and subscribe. Hit the bell icon for more updates.